once beautiful sons and daughters hoarding fragments, lording and ladying and burning from the altars of their lips, all instinct still migratory. Within the paths of free to the promontory, decay at the turning of the sky. They hobble to the one tree where an attendant is also a boatman, and negotiate a passage back. I am pressed to vertical earth, hatless, mapless, and without sunglasses. Golden-bellied birds flash in a swift geometry upon lapis lazuli, and I tremble with the thrill of superstition. What spirits are these? Whose soul cries from the mouth of the ass? Now the water is a leviathan ready to swallow. Thrashes about not content with its containment, neither convinced nor concerned that lungs need land. Spakia wheeze and sleep with mouths open and lamps glaring and garments pressed to their eyes. Their Messiah were to come in the night. I could not follow, for this is not a diaspora, and the Son and the Father are only one half of one God. I wonder why the earth supports us. We expect so much and renew so little. It's hero and husband back and forth and up and down, scattering the bones of aborted destinies. He first slurred the ancient name of this place, Hora Sfakia. The horrors of Sfakia, he announced, and everyone laughed, then laughed again and laughed all the next day. Now she and he and I are pigs upon sand. We offer our knees to the waves, and Hero calls, and her call takes the body of a gull.